all about unity, no beginning, no end. And it's my personal belief that our soul will continue. It's quite difficult to explain. It could get really deep and very philosophical, but I think the simplest way is hula hoops. It's a plastic tube, really, but it's a symbol that is found all over in nature itself. Unity, it's never ending, it's never beginning, it's continuous. And I think because it's a circle, and because our bodies are round, it works well for dance in that way. It's the amount of things you can do with a circle, and you and your movement and your power is almost infinite, really. And that infiniteness, that's what I like, because I'd like to believe that we will always continue in our souls onwards. I basically set up the UK Hoop Gathering project just as a kind of term for bringing together the hoop community, because a lot of people have talked about it, but no one's actually gone and done it. I thought, well, time's going by, so I'll just do it.
Most of you know I went over to the Hoop Camp retreat in the States in September, and it was absolutely magical. Like, words can't describe how brilliant it was. And I just thought, wouldn't it be so awesome if we had a similar thing here, or some kind of big event where we can all kind of congregate and hoop and party and meet each other. Time to get down.
I'm healthier, I'm clearer, I'm more focused. If I had my wicked way, I would hoop all day long.
I actually got a hoop last April, and then it's just been a bit of an obsession since then, really.
I met this crazy little American girl called Kate who kept banging on about hooping, and I just thought she was really strange. And she made me get her a hoop, and she tried to show me some stuff and I just couldn't manage it, and I came back and I didn't pick up a hoop for like 6 months. Then I wanted to like tone up, so I bought myself a hoop just over 18 months ago. And yeah, and I've not put it down.
I got into hooping about 22 years ago. I went to a television programme and they've got the World Hula Hoop Champion there. And he was asking for volunteers out of the audience. And my sister pushed me out of the audience. and it started from there, really.
It was Gemma that discovered it, really. I've done Fireboy for years and years, probably about 5 years when I was at uni. And then Gemma picked up a hoop and she was just like, "It's the most amazing thing ever, you have to have a go."
They will hoop a lot, loads actually. They are all hooping all the time and they still keep going. I said hoopers are like the Duracell bunny, you know, they just keep going and going and going and going because they love the hoop so much, basically. What they'd expect is yurts, interesting structures to hang out in, fire LED hoop opportunities, workshops in which they can develop particular skills and techniques, also community vibe, shared dinners. We're all sleeping in dormitories or camping, so you're staying close to people all the time, so kind of make those bonds with people as well. I thought it wouldn't work if we just had hooping all weekend, because even though we love hooping and we would do it, it's nice to introduce other disciplines or other creative movement arts, really. So we invited V and Eleanor to do some burlesque and some pole dancing as well, which just adds a really kinky, fun, light-hearted kind of aspect to it. And also you can do burlesque hooping, so I thought it kind of ties in as well. It's moving, it's fun, it's different. We've also got Five Rhythms Dancing, which is an ecstatic trance dance facilitated by Neil, who actually lives here. Bringing so much from drum jams, come here with absolutely loads of drums, and we've been doing some really nice percussive hooping sessions as well.
People that I've never seen before, and loads of like new styles, like twins and partner hooping and things like that that I just haven't really done before.
My name is Emily, also known as Tilly Twist, and I act as the Patalunis.
I'm Hobbit, also known as Shanti. we rave around with a massive hula hoop.
It's this big.
Hooping is for anyone who wants to rediscover themselves in a new way. You have to have a sense of humour to pick this up and want to spin it around your waist in the first place. It's for people who want to develop core strength, coordination, burn calories, gain muscle, And also it's just great for community. As you've seen, there's absolutely loads of hoopers having a wicked time. On so many levels, it resonates with so many different people. It just brings joy.
I'm part of a group called the Hoop Path. It's a curriculum and a way of hooping that a man named Jonathan Baxter founded and created. And it's about finding oneself within this dance with the hoop. It's a path that we each take. The hoop is different things for me, and there are times when the hoop actually acts for me as sort of armor. I feel at times that it protects me and keeps me safe. And then at other times it's sort of the opposite, in that it becomes the vehicle through which I actually come out, because normally I'm kind of an internal person. And so I find myself doing stuff and it's like, here I am coming out through the hoop, and I didn't know that's who I was. And so it's a discovery for myself as well. I think the motion of the hoop is, there's a feeling of rocking, of being cradled, that is very soothing. and calming. I think that it calms my central nervous system. I hoop in both directions, and I think that that helps balance me. There's a lot of crossing of the midline of my hands to other parts of my body, so there's a connection between my hands and my legs, or, you know, other parts of my body, so that I feel like perhaps something is happening in my brain that is opening up channels that were once kind of stuck.
The sunsets were purple and red and yellow on fire, and the clouds would catch the colors everywhere. That's neat, because I used to look at them all the time when I was little. You don't see that.
For me, it's a tool to facilitate self-belief, self-growth, self-expression. For me, it's been a massive boost in self-esteem. It's lifted me up from a really dark place. It's given me a career, prospects. The actual act of hooping in itself releases endorphins because you're spinning, you're moving, you're active. In order to learn tricks, you need to be aware of your body, so you bring your attention to different parts of you, so you connect with your body more deeply than you would before. And also the act of spinning, if you think about the Sufis, you can elevate your consciousness to higher levels. And when you see a hoop dancer really just in her flow, at her peak, you can just see that she's free. It's just absolutely taken away to another place.
They went on forever. We lived in Arizona, and the skies always had little fluffy clouds, and we moved down. They were long and clear, and there were lots of stars. And when it would rain, it would all turn. They were beautiful, the most beautiful skies, as a matter of fact. The sunsets were purple and red and yellow and on fire, and the clouds would catch the colors everywhere. That's neat, because I used to look at them all the time. You don't see that in the clouds, little fluffy clouds.
Well, initially it was about, I want to look cool. Or that looks cool, and I wanted to know what that feels like to do that. That was my initial reaction. When I saw Spiral, she was just so beautiful, and I thought, well, I'm not going to be beautiful like that. I can't look like her. But I want to know what it feels like to move that way, because the movement itself is so beautiful.
So there's a way of moving with the hoop that we call paddling. And a paddle is basically an insertion of usually the hand, the forearm, usually the back of the hand, the back of the forearm, into the current, much like you would put a paddle or an oar into water. And what I'm going to do is put it into this open window between the hoop and my body. It's going to be opposite the point of contact, which is constantly moving around. And what I do is I insert my hand, and I basically let my hand take on the energy from my core, and it no longer is expressed directly from my core to the hoop, but it's expressed through my hand. But it still feels like it emanates from the core to me. So I might do something like that. It's a very simple movement. I can do it with either hand. I can use a paddle to move the hoop up my body. Once I get it up here, this really magical thing happens where I can lift the hoop, straighten out the plane of the hoop. I can add energy to it, make it go faster. And sometimes when I'm doing this, I'm thinking about, how do I get my daughter to school? I gotta get her up. Good, she's up. Give her a little bit more energy. She's had breakfast, got her shoes, her bag. She's out the door, and now she's at school. So it's about moving the hoop in the direction that it's already going in a way that disrupts its flow as little as possible. It's adding energy as opposed to working against the energy that's already there.
It's magical in some ways, but no more magical than the fact that we have spring, summer, fall, and winter. You know, I feel like the world itself is so amazingly magical that we don't really have to add anything to it. Thank you.
for the UK hoop gathering because it's in the UK and it's for everyone, but I was anticipating that we'd be mainly UK hoopers, which it is. We've got people from England, Wales, Scotland. We've got one girl from Iceland. Two girls come over from Holland. We've got Beth Lavinder from North Carolina in the US. And another lady who's come over from Texas as well. So we've got a really nice mix of European, international and UK as well.
Iceland, and I'm best hooper in Iceland. I'm almost the only one in Iceland, so I'm gonna bring a lot back with me and try to get other people, smitten too.
I came from Manchester with a marvellous friendship. I've been only learning tricks since about April. I love it!
It's been really nice to come here and just learn a lot of skills that I haven't got yet, but I will get.
It's a beautiful community, you know, the hoopers are really friendly and really lovely ladies, and it's just great to see people being creative.
It's been great to have so many UK hoopers together in one spot for the first time ever, and to see how different everyone is.
Just watching somebody else who you consider to be professional and somebody that you look up to, I want to be like them one day, to watch how they learn something new, get it wrong and work at it.
How's that been for you?
A bit overwhelming, probably.
Yeah, I didn't expect there to be other men here, to be honest. I expected to be the only one, so it was nice to see some of the male hoopers.
A lot of the guys are exploring styles that I think have a more masculine appearance because they're sort of ninja-like. So the paddling and the breaking that Baxter does has the... You know, one could look at this and think, well, she's fighting an opponent. This isn't, you know, the round, sensuous dancing that one sees from women.
It's like a dream for me that it's actually happening. To spend such a long time and put your heart and your soul and your passion into it, and then to actually see it working, and not just working, working better than you ever thought it was. Still, shock. I don't know what's going on. It's amazing. It's going to take me months to digest actually what's happening. And that's brilliant. It's a really good feeling.
At first I found it really, really overwhelming because I thought I was a pretty good hooper, and then I came here and looked at people hooping and was just like, oh my god, I can't believe that you can do that with a hoop. Especially people like Beth and Sharna and Tilly and Hobbit, just absolutely amazing hoopers. And the different things that you can do with a hoop as well is absolutely mind-blowing.
It's actually really, really nice to be with loads and loads of other women. There's a few guys here and the guys are amazing, but it's really, really, really nice to just be with like what, 50 women, all just having a marvellous time.
Everyone's just buzzing about teaching each other new tricks and like helping each other out.
The main thing I'm taking from it is the complete friendliness and community spirit that is here. I think it's absolutely amazing.
The Five Reasons Dance was brilliant, just watching everyone totally let go of themselves. The burlesque was awesome. I got to shake my ass in front of a whole crowd of people, which is nice.
I've discovered that I love pole dancing. And five rhythms dancing are kind of miles apart on the whole scale of hippiness to sleazy, I guess.
Yeah, just being with other hoopers, because from where I am, Norwich, there's not so many people doing it.
There's just great little moments, you know, different workshops and then the performances last night, and you know, the burlesque was great, and the naked fire hooping. And then the blindfolded naked fire hooping.
I genuinely came in thinking, oh, I mean, it's wicked. Like, fair play, people pole dance, people burlesque, you know, five rhythms dance or whatever. And I came in, I was so cynical, like, to the point of, like, I was even considering not even going. I mean, the five rhythms dance was just insane. I mean, it really was, like, such a brilliant experience, and I would recommend it to everyone. And the burlesque was just, I mean, incredible what happens when you put on a boa or a pair of gloves. I wasn't expecting that at all. And then the pole dancing this morning, it's something that I would never in a million years have tried. Yeah, you know, sliding down a pole backwards earlier on today, it was amazing.
I think yesterday completely was beautiful. Showcases yesterday, they were a lot of fun.
On something, it's okay, that's fine, and that you shouldn't beat yourself up. If you do something and it's not quite right, you just pick up and you carry on and you keep going.
What I've really loved is that you watch people that have inspired you learn something new and watch the absolute like you that drop your hoop.
Wondering why you're not home. The light. I'll go beside you, let before you try to work out all the unknowns. Blame it all on me when I forget to defend everything that we've worked out. Something in her wording, I cannot help searching for one memory found. Thought it stopped just as it started. That is not what I feel.
Personal belief that our soul will continue.